I'm going to need to run to the car to get a charger because it looks like my battery is weak. So okay. Give me, keep until I get the charger and come back.
Okay, inshallah. Please.
Inshallah.
Are we live now, Firoz?
Yes, we are live.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, dear brothers and sisters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us our fasting, our salawat, our qiyam, our sadaqat, and all our deeds. We are close to the end of Ramadan. Subhanallah, Ramadan running very fast as usual. It's because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ayyaman ma'dudat, ayyaman ma'dudat, limit days, limit time. So we have to take advantage to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this limit time, because those days has a barakah, special days. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says about the last 10 nights of Ramadan, last days, the Prophet was treated those days with a special way. كان إذا دخل أيام العشر أيقظ أهله أحيا ليله وشد المئزر. Inshallah, we will continue the next 15 minutes with our guest, Dr. Abbasi. Please, Dr. Fadl.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Can you hear my voice, Akhi?
Yes.
واضح؟ طيب. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. As the Sheikh was saying, tonight is probably one of the five possible nights of Laylatul Qadr. And there is a lot that can be said about Laylatul Qadr, but I'm going to touch on just a couple of things that are relevant to our daily life nowadays. But before I do that, I'd like to bring attention to an interesting observation, a few interesting observations about Surah Al-Qadr itself that I borrowed from the great Mufassir Bayani. His name is Fadl Rajih Hassan al-Ra'i. He said, subhanAllah, to understand a surah or an ayah, you have to understand the context, what came before it and what comes after it. If you look at Surah Al-Qadr, it's preceded, which is surah number 96. It's preceded, number 97. It's preceded by surah number 96, which is Surah Al-Alaq, the clot. That surah starts with Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Iqra, the first words in the Quran. But it doesn't say what to read. It says Iqra or recite, but doesn't say what to recite. It just says Iqra, in the name of your Lord, recite. And it ends with the words, Kalla la tuti', sanad'u al-zabaniya, Kalla la tuti'hu, wasjud, waqtarib. There's a call to make sujood at the end of the surah. The last ayah is ordering the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make sujood and to come closer to Allah azza wa jal. So that's Surah Al-Alaq, the clot. Immediately after that comes Surah Laylat Al-Qadr, Surah Al-Qadr. Surah Al-Qadr answers the unanswered questions of Surah Al-Alaq. For Surah Al-Alaq says Iqra, but it doesn't say what. And it wants the Prophet to do certain things, but it doesn't explain exactly how. So Surah Al-Qadr comes in and says basically, Iqra bismi, it says, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr, wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr khayrun min alfi shahr, tanazzal malaikatu ruhu fiha bi'idhni rabbihim kulli amr, salamun hiya. حتى مطلع الفجر. There is so much that could be said about the surah, but just to connect it with the previous surah, where it shows us, it shows to us that the answer to Iqra is this Quran that Allah Azza wa Jal refers to in the surah as Inna Anzalnahu. But notice again, in the surah, it speaks in the pronouns. There is the plural pronoun, or the pronoun of greatness, Dhamir al-Azama, Inna. But it doesn't say, it doesn't tell us who is talking. We assume it is Allah Azza wa Jal because we know that now. But the language of the Quran is very specific. It says, Inna Anzalnahu, and it talks about it being sent down, but it doesn't say what it is. Anzalnahu. There's another pronoun here. It. Inna Anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr. It doesn't clarify any of that. We are expected to understand that, but in reality, it's not clear until Surah Al-Bayyinah comes. And Bayyinah is revelation. Bayyinah reveals the unknown things that are mentioned in Surah Al-Qadr. So when you read Surah Al-Bayyinah, in the second ayah, it says, رَسُولٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ يَتْلُو صُحُفًا مُطَهَّرًا. فيها كتب قيمة. It explains what it is that's being revealed. It tells us who is receiving it, because Surah Al-Qadr doesn't tell us who is receiving the revelation. Here it tells us that there is a Rasul, Rasulun min Allah, and what does he do? يَتْلُو صُحُفًا مُطَهَّرًا. He's reciting sacred script. فِيهَا كُتُبٌ قَيِّمَةٌ. There are laws that are revealed unto it. And of course, it explains that this is all from Allah. So these three surahs are connected. The first one hints to what is to come. The second one tells us what is coming and from where and to whom, but only in the pronoun, with pronouns referencing the answer. The third surah, Surah Al-Bayyinah, the word bayyinah means revelation. Bayyanat, or clarified all of those meanings. So that's an interesting observation from Dr. Fadl Raji Hassan al-Ra'i. There's a couple of other observations that I'd like to share with you that you may or may not have heard, and none of these are deterministic, meaning that they are simply observations. No one is to use them as evidence for anything. The first one is that this surah is only five ayat, and it is the same number of the odd nights that could be possible, Laylatul Qadr, number one. Number two, another observation is the word Laylatul Qadr, the phrase Laylatul Qadr, or the night of Qadr, which in a moment I'll explain, it's not just night of power, there's other meanings. Laylatul Qadr is nine letters. And it's repeated three times. Three times nine is 27. So some of the scholars said that hints that it is the 27th night. Also, the entire surah is 30 words. Number 27, the word 27 is here, which means it. And a lot of people use that as some kind of an indication that it could be Laylatul Qadr, the 27th, because this 27th reference in the surah. These are simply observations that I picked up from Father Rajah Samurai. Now let's come to the meaning of Al-Qadr. Translated mostly by Yusuf Ali and others as night of power. And the truth is power from the word Qudra or ability is only one of the meanings. I went to a dictionary called Lisan al-Arab, which is the greatest dictionary of Arabic words, especially the words that are revealed in the Quran. It has probably millions of words in it. I don't even know how many volumes, probably 20 volumes. And I looked up the word Qadr or Qadara, the three-letter root word from Qadr or Qadara. There's about 6-7 pages on the meaning of the word Qadr. And yet it is translated loosely into one single meaning among all of those meanings that appear in 6-7 pages of explanation. Power. But in reality, if you read the Quran itself, you'll see that there's an ayah that says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ means that they did not glorify Allah or uphold Allah Azza wa Jalla and their value in high esteem as they should. So here, وَمَا قَدَرُ means they did not assign the proper value. When I teach a course about life values, I actually have a course called My Life on Purpose. I always talk about the importance of determining what are the most important values in a person's life. And I always mention that the Quran gave us or assigned to us the first two values that one should recognize as being important in his life. In Surah Al-Isra, Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. The top two values in our life should be Allah Azza wa Jal and Al-Walidain, the parents. That's number one and number two in that order. Of course, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are other values depending on one's circumstances. If somebody is sick, his next most important value is health, is getting healthy. If somebody is poor, his next most important value is to earn a living so that he can eat and can pay the bills. And if somebody is a student, he has to graduate. So our values change based on circumstances. But number one and two do not change. So Laylatul Qadr, the word Qadr, one of its meanings, in addition to power, is the, and this is my humble opinion, and I'm sure others must have mentioned it, but I like to stick with this meaning. I like to think of it as the night in which Allah Azza wa Jal assigned value to things. We say in modern language, New World Order. You keep hearing people from the days of President Bush say New World Order. And it was mentioned also before during the days of Margaret Thatcher, New World Order. Well, the real New World Order, the re-evaluation or re-evaluation in this life, on this earth, really took place on the night of Laylatul Qadr. It took place in the revelation of the Quran and the coming of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So when we think of Laylatul Qadr, we need to think of it as the time in which Allah Azza wa Jal decided that it is time to basically reinitiate or reevaluate people's values for themselves so that they can live a happy life. I hope and pray to Allah Azza wa Jal that we put the Laylatul Qadr and the meanings of Surah Al-Qadr in the proper perspective, and then we take a look at our personal values during these nights and other holy nights, and to make sure to assign the highest value in our life to Allah Azza wa Jal in Ibadatullah, and also to Ridha Al-Walidain, taking care of our parents. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. I hope that this was beneficial. جزاكم الله خيرا for listening. Sheikh Nadi, I turn the microphone back to you.
جزاكم الله خيرا دكتور. بارك الله فيك for this important message, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us. Inshallah, we will stay a few more minutes with Adhkaru al-Masa together as usual. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladhina an'amta 'alayhim ghayril maghdubi 'alayhim waladdallin. Amin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alif Lam Mim. Dhalikal kitabu la rayba fihi hudan lil muttaqin. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون
والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس أمسينا وأمسى الملك لله والحمد لله لا شريك له لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير أمسينا وأمسى الملك لله والحمد لله لا شريك له لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير أمسينا على فطرة الإسلام وكلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين اللهم إنا أمسينا منك في نعمة وعافية وستر فأتم علينا نعمتك وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم إنا أمسينا منك في نعمة وعافية وستر فأتم علينا نعمتك وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم ما أمسى بنا من نعمة أو بأحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك فلك الحمد ولك الشكر يا رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك عظيم سلطانك يا رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك عظيم سلطانك بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا آمنا بالله العظيم وحده وكفرنا بالجبت والطاغوت واستمسكنا بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته
سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت، خلقتني وأنا عبدك، وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت، أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي، فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن، ونعوذ بك من العجز والكسل، ونعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل، ونعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. اللهم عافنا في أبداننا، اللهم عافنا في أسماعنا، اللهم عافنا في أبصارنا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. نستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليه. نعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق، نعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق، نعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق، نعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة ومن كل عين لامة. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما عدد ما أحاط به علمك وخط به قلمك وأحصاه كتابك. وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وارض عنا معهم يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح.
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آتي سيدنا محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة والدرجة الرفيعة وابعثه اللهم المقام المحمود الذي وعدته إنك لا تخلف الميعاد وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.